So we just got Studio Card for Dimension Force. An uneducated person would look at these cards and say they're terrible. Somebody that actually knows what they're talking about will realize, wait, these cards are busted and might be comparable to Soy Phoenix of Force. So this fusion is really insane, so it's the trap, let's look at them. I'd say since it's the fusion, the trap fusion summons, let's look at it first. So this is Dynorphia Frenzy, by the way. This archetype has a monster that just search spell trap for this archetype and summon. During your opponent's main phase, you can pay half of your life points. So fusion summon a Dynorphia fusion monster from your extra deck using one monster from your deck and one monster from your extra deck. That's right. It's virtually a Shadow fusion, except there's no requirements for your opponent whatsoever. You just need to control this trap. Attack the fact, not really that relevant when your opponent activates a card or effect while your life points are 2 cards or less. You can banish this card from your grave, you take no damage from your opponent's card effects this turn. I suppose it can protect you against dying, but yeah. Attack the fact is that great first effect, just fusion with materials from your main deck and extra deck. Brilliant, if you have the right target. Now, take a look at this fusion monster. Dinorphia Rex turn. Level 8 Dark Dinosaur fusion effect monster, 2,000 attack, 0 defense. Materials are Dinorphia fusion monster plus a Dinorphia monster. Which could be another copy of, you know, Hexstorming extra deck, just saying. Second turn effects of cards are once per turn, okay. Monster your opponent controls with an attack equal or higher than your life points cannot activate their effects. That's interesting. We use the trap to halve our life points. Its second effect halves your life points, so you have a floodgate for 2. You have basically Destiny Plasma affecting 2000 higher at that point. However, they have a fusion monster that can copy a trap from your grave. Meaning, if you have the right amount of cards in your extra deck and main deck, one could just easily reach 1000 life points and your opponent cannot activate anything with 1000 more attack. Yeah. However, there's also a second effect on this card. Quick effect. You can pay half your life points until the end of this turn, the attack of all monsters your opponent controls becomes equal to your life points. Now, there's something a bit unclear to this effect, about this effect to me. It doesn't state I currently control, so I would assume any monster I summon for the rest of the turn is also affected. If that's the case, this just basically is a worse Calamities. Now, it's not on the same level. If they remove this from the field, it actually stops working. But they need to remove it from the field, and that's 3000 attack, and monster effects will get negated. Regardless, at worst, it's comparable to something like a Zodiac Trident. Oh yeah, there's also a third effect. If this card is destroyed in battle or by a card effect, especially on level 6 or lower, Dinorphia monster from your graveyard. It even floats, so that's the other fusion. So, in exchange for a lot of life points, you're getting a one-sided skill drain. The trap, if you draw it, can just be used with materials from your deck, you don't need anything else. If you draw the monster, you can normal summon it, so any deck that doesn't really use its normal summons can use it. Now, as you now might know on this channel, we're doing Red Dragon Archfiend Week. Now, how is this any relevant? I'll talk more about it in a future video, but a level 4 Dark Dinosaur, easy searchable, fusion summoning in your opponent's turn. Yeah, I shouldn't need to explain much more. I'll do it soon anyway, but just know that Dinorphia Red Dragon Archfiend will probably be the best variant. Just say. So these cards are insane and somewhat comparable to Destroy Phoenix Enforcer. Granted, you can't just summon this off a link too. We actually need to get the trap in your hands at some point. If you're able to do this, well, that's very, very, very nasty. So I hope you all liked the review. Hope you all have a beautiful day. Goodbye.